We welcome those of you who have just joined us. Kenny Albert with Pierre Maguire inside the glass.
One of the referees told me that they can actually hear me on the ice during the game, which is definitely unique.
Well, they got two-thirds of that 70s line from the LA Kings here, Kenny. Tanner Pearson, Tyler Toffoli.
It's a weird experience for me. Basically, I hang around with my broadcast partner, Kenny Albert. It's kind of unique to be in one place for such a long period of time.
I think we've all settled into a routine. It feels like Groundhog Day.
Well, my day started around 5:30 a.m. because I'm doing radio back to the East Coast.
Around noon, I head over to the arena for the daily COVID test. Then I usually play ping pong. I've been doing that for the last week or so with a couple of different folks, and we've had some pretty competitive games.
Get that?
By being here in the bubble, Pierre and I have actually run into a number of players and coaches in the plaza outside, and we're able to have some informal conversations.
The access we've had to the players and coaches while not in the rink has probably been better than what I would get during the playoffs any other time, so I'm really grateful for that.
Just looking over the notes from game one and prepared my new sheet for game two. Prep gets a little bit easier in the playoffs when you see the same teams constantly over the course of a series or multiple series.
Just doing power play, goals for, goals against, power play in the series, previous series records. I try to memorize this before the game, that's why I write it out. Because when you're working down low, you don't really want to be looking at your papers, you want to be looking at the game. So when I find I can memorize more when I write it down first, so that's before every game I do that. And this would be all the games that I've done so far in this tournament and all the writings that I've done since we started. So you can see they're all just sheets that I use and go back and study and break down.
1-0, Pierre.
Thank you.
Richie has the goal.
It's kind of a unique situation here, not having fans in the building. The intensity of an NHL warm-up, when the fans are coming in, the music is pulsating, you feel it at ice level. Here, it's a little bit different, obviously.
Stamford, Connecticut, it's Pierre. How you doing there, Matthew? Really good. Did you guys have a chance to cut all that tape that I asked? Yeah, I don't mind looking at it at all, thank you. That's good. Perfect. Overtime winner, perfect.
Usually I'm talking to our truck all the time during warm-ups, building packages, focusing on maybe an injured player and how he's doing, so we can get camera shots of him.
You know, I was just talking to Reeves down in the dressing room area, so no, he knows he can't take penalties against Roussel. That's a real big part of it. That's going to be a huge storyline here tonight.
It's a tremendous broadcast location. In most NHL buildings, we are all the way up in the press box at the top of the building, higher than all of the fans. Here in Edmonton, due to the fact that there are no fans, the NHL was able to set up a broadcast platform for us behind the first 20 or 25 rows on the main concourse.
Faceoff won by Horvat. Edler with a shot, missed the net to the right.
When you're in between the benches, you can hear both benches. So here, the only thing you're missing is you're not hearing the far bench.
Bigasson cuts wide on Shea Theodore. Stuff attempt and then Toffoli scores! His first shift back.
Toffoli takes advantage and you see how they get up 1-0. Just a simple little breakdown, but a real good job by Toffoli getting to where he has to go to score.
I think we figured out the system. It didn't take too long and hopefully it's not really noticeable to the viewers and listeners.
Here at Edmonton, 2-0. Vancouver